Next one, we will be doing food tests. Food tests, you can actually test for carbohydrate, test for fats, and test for protein. Carbohydrates, you can test for two. You can test for here. You can test for starch. You can test for reducing sugar. How to test for starch? You use iodine solution. Iodine solution will turn from brown to blue-black if starch is present. Benedict solution will turn from blue to brick red precipitate if reducing sugar is present. Fats. Here, we are going to test for fats. So if fats is present, clear solution will turn cloudy. If fats is absent, of course, it will remain clear. Protein, it will turn from blue to violet if protein is present. Okay, very simple. Okay, so there are steps required when you carry out this test. Step for iodine's test would be quite easy. Number one, you just get the iodine solution and add drop-wise to starch solution or to the sample that might or might not contain starch. Okay? Benedict solution, quite easy as well. You just add equal amount of Benedict solution to the sample. Okay, there is something very special over here. You need to warm the solution, warm the mixture. You need to warm the mixture in a water bath. Okay, this is special. The rest don't really need any heating through water bath. Only reducing sugar is special. For fats, there's no heating as well. But there are two steps required. First, you need to add equal amount of ethanol. To the solution. At this point, the content of the tube should be clear. If there is fat or if there is no fat, both of them will give you a clear result. Subsequently, you add water, equal amount of water. Okay, then you can see distinction. If there is fats, you will see cloud dissolution forming. If there's no fat, then it will remain clear. Okay, next. Let's take a look at protein. Protein, in this case, there's just one step, very easy. You add equal amount of burette solution. Burette reagent also can. Then you straight away observe the color change. Okay, simple as that. So